Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning, brothers and sisters. And welcome to this day's celebration. Happy Easter, everyone. It's an Hallelujah Sunday. Happy Easter, happy resurrection. The stone is rolled away. Amen. Just to inform you that you will need a candle for today's celebration. So the ushers to the back have the candles for you. So if you do not have one yet, you go to them and to get a candle for today's celebration. It is Easter Sunday, Resurrection of the Lord, Year B. You can find this in your Missal, Sunday Missal. The first reading is taken from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, verses 34 and 37 to 43. Second reading is taken from the book of Colossians, chapter 3, verses 1 through to 4. And the gospel is taken from the gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 1 through to 9. Just to remind you also, sisters and brothers, that it is an Hallelujah Sunday, and we are an Hallelujah people. That means we participate in the celebration, in the singing of the songs, and we have our monitors. The screens are all over the church, or you should have your moments of celebration. The choir is there to help guide the singing, but we need to hear the entire church as one voice, one Hallelujah people giving praise to Jesus for his resurrection. Amen? Amen? Amen. Right. So I want to hear every one of you sing as loudly as you can for this very, very special Sunday. This is the best and highest Sunday in our church's calendar. Those of you who are watching virtually, online, from home, or from wherever you are, in your car, if you are at home, take out your moments of celebration. Take out your missal. Turn off the stove. Find a comfortable space and join us in this celebration. It is not something that we can celebrate while we're cooking. Let us take special time aside for Jesus. Put away the breakfast for a little while and spend a moment with Jesus, giving him thanks and praise for his saving of us through his resurrection from the cross. The stone is rolled away. And now, I invite us all to stand, about to sing our entrance hymn together in one voice as an Hallelujah people, number 48 in your moments of celebration. Christ the Lord is risen today. Remember to check your phones to make sure your phones are on silent or they're off, please.
The communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sisters and brothers, we've made it 6 weeks of Lent, but we've made it to today. Today basically is a celebration of a fulfillment of God's love for us. And because we sin, because we have not done things the way we're supposed to do, we fall short of the glory of God. We ask God, we pause, we ask God for pardon, mercy, and strength to do better. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us all our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
us this morning is for the intentions of all of our parishioners, not only those who are here, but those who are following us virtually, who have adopted us as their parish. We continue to pray also for all those who have asked of our prayers, all those who are visiting with us. We pray for you this morning during our Easter morning liturgy. We welcome the sisters of the missionary sisters who are celebrating with us this morning.
In addition, this morning we pray for Beryl Charles, for the management and staff of rituals at Uranora, for those celebrating birthdays, for Teresa Florius, Alban Louis, Janie Dozite Fede, Jermaine Rambali. We also pray for deceased, for Clement Daniel Florius, for Peter Louis, and especially for our donors, our benefactors, those who have been good to the parish. We pray for them.
We also pray for the various persons, whether you do not belong to the Catholic faith, who continue to stop me on the streets and says, "Father, you know, we're following you." You know, we want to pray this morning especially for the team at the MNC drugstore at Rodney Bay, you know, and all those men and women of goodwill. We pray for you this morning as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. So I saw a lady arrived a while ago in a wheelchair. You can bring her somewhere to the front, and there's space for her, please.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter addressed Cornelius and his household. "You must have heard about the recent happenings in Judea, about Jesus of Nazareth and how he began in Galilee after John had been preaching baptism. God had anointed him with the Holy Spirit and with power. And because God was with him, Jesus went about doing good and curing all who had fallen into the power of the devil. Now I and those with me can witness to everything he did throughout the countryside of Judea and in Jerusalem itself, and also to the fact that they killed him by hanging him on a tree. Yet 3 days afterwards, God raised him to life and allowed him to be seen, not by the whole people, but only by certain witnesses of God who had certain witnesses God had chosen beforehand. Now we are those witnesses. We have eaten and drunk with him after his resurrection from the dead. It is to him that all prophets bear this witness, that all who believe in Jesus will have their sins forgiven through his name." The word of the Lord.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let
Let us rejoice and be glad.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
For his love has no end.
Let the sons of Israel say,
from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Since you have been brought back to true life with Christ, you must look for the things that are in heaven, where Christ is, sitting at God's right hand. Let your thoughts be on heavenly things, not on the things that are on the earth, because you have died, and now the life you have is hidden with Christ in God. But when Christ is revealed, and he is your life, you too will be revealed in all your glory with him. The word of the Lord.
Victim, offer sacrifice and praise. The sheep are ransomed by the Lamb, and Christ, the undefiled, have sinners to his Father reconciled. Death with the life contended, combat strangely ended. Life's own champion slain, yet life's reign, yet lives to reign. Tell us, Mary, say what thou didst see upon the way. The tomb, the living did it enclose. I saw Christ's glory as he rose. The angels there attesting, shroud with grave clothes resting. Christ, my hope, has risen. He goes before you into Galilee. That Christ is truly risen from the dead, we know. Victorious King, thy mercy show.
Hallelujah, hallelujah,
Our Passover has been sacrificed. Let us celebrate the feast then in the Lord. Alleluia.
According to John.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
It was very early on the first day of the week and still dark when Mary of Magdala came to the tomb. She saw that the stone had been moved away from the tomb and came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved. "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb," she said, "and we do not know where they have put him." So Peter set out with the other disciple to go to the tomb. They ran together, but the other disciple, running faster than Peter, reached the tomb first. He bent down and saw the linen cloths lying on the ground, but did not go in. Simon Peter, who was following now, came up, went right into the tomb, saw the linen cloths on the ground, and also the cloth that had been over his head. This was not with the linen cloths, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who had reached the tomb first also went in. He saw and he believed. Till this moment, they had failed to understand the teaching of Scripture that he must rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
I want to be loved, not for who you think I am, nor what you want me to be. Could you love me for me? Could you love me for me? Real love, no strings attached. I want to give you my heart, not want to take it back. And this is my chat. What is your chat to God this morning? What is your chat to God this morning? God is begging us to love us. God is going out of his way to show us his love for us. Not true? Huh? Yes. God gave us his love. God sent Jesus Christ to show us the extent of his love for us as human beings while we were still sinners. Buju Banton put it nicely. I want to be loved. Not for who you think I am, nor for what you want me to be. Many of us, we want people to change for us to love them. Huh? Let's talk this morning. Let's wrap. Many of us, we want people to change for us to love them. True or false? True or false? But God don't want that from us. God loves us just as we are. And in the process of loving us, he calls us to change. He loves us as we are. God loves us broken. He loves us wounded. He loves us bruised and invites us to change in the process of him loving us. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever may believeth in him may have life and not perish. Easter, for me, you know, I was thinking of what do I say this morning? What do I say last night? And you know, because we've journeyed over the last few weeks. But for me, my own personal conviction, Easter is a fulfillment of an expression of love by God through Jesus Christ. An expression of love by God through Jesus Christ. Christ mounted the wood of the cross, not true? For our sake. You know, and I was saying to the congregation last night that in those days, that was the worst kind of death. This death by crucifixion was reserved for criminals. So Jesus embraced a criminal's death for us. What are you prepared to embrace so that others may leave this Sunday morning, this Easter Sunday morning? What is it that you are prepared to embrace? You know, very often we are so comfortable in our own way of living. We are so comfortable in the way of doing things. And that is why, you know, people say, oh, Petlaka hate a power, because they're very comfortable and they do not want to change. You know, Cardinal Henry Newman once said, to change is to grow, and to have change often is to become perfect. To change is to grow, and to have change often is to become perfect. Jesus says, be perfect as my heavenly Father is perfect. Do you want to be perfect? Do you want to be perfect, sisters and brothers? Dabawibon. C'est un monde qui te doit une vieille conversation à sous chemin, ou qu'a oublié c'est la mer sous sortie. Hein? Ou qu'a oublié c'est la mer sous sortie. Do you want to be perfect? It's because God wants us as we are, and God wants to make us perfect. God wants to make us perfect. John 3:16. No greater love that you can have than to lay down your life for your friend. God is love. And for love to flourish, we must be rooted in love. We must be rooted in God. God is love, and the one who lives in God lives in love, and God lives in him. Are you living in love this morning? Are you living in love this morning? Are you a loving person? Are we a loving country? Are we a loving community? Now? Are we? I fell happy with the people who are here. Tout ces mounas ka cheba chair. All the people you have living in the tomb this morning, go and make peace with them. Jesus is risen from the tomb. He's broken the barriers. He's come out of his tomb. You too need to come out of your tomb. You too need to come out of your tomb. John 15:13 says, no greater love has no man than to lay down his life for his friend. Celebrating the resurrection is a reassurance of that great love. Jesus coming from the tombs, overcoming shame, sin, and death. Overcoming shame, sin, and death. Sisters and brothers, we have gone through the Lenten journey. We have gone through the Easter Triduum, and now we are at a high point. We're on a high. But you can only be on the high if you made the necessary preparations. If you made the necessary preparations. His tomb is empty. The angels rolled the stone away. It was early Easter Sunday morning when the angels rolled the stone away. And Jesus too wants to roll your stone away. Jesus wants to empty your tombs. Your tombs of hate. Your tombs of greed. Your tombs of jealousy. Your tombs of envy. Your tombs of lack of forgiveness. Your tombs of prejudices. Your tombs of the sickness, the various sickness we carry in our bodies. The tombs of racism. The tombs of two-face. Many of us are in tombs. Many of us are in tombs, not one more than the other. So our daddy says, look at it, by moon, sir, father, kadisai. Look at your own tomb. What is your tomb? What is holding you back so that you cannot live the life that God wants you to live? What is that tomb? What is that tomb? Jesus wants to liberate us and make us free agents of love. Jesus wants to liberate us and to make us free agents of love. Jesus wants us to give that unconditional love that he gives to us to others. Jesus loves us unconditionally. Unconditionally. And he wants us to give to others that same love, unconditional love. You know, in families, sometimes people say, you know, the children ask, Mommy, you love me? Or Daddy, you love me? Yes, but you have to do this. But you have to do this. But you have to do this. Not true? Not true? Yes, man, he's me myself because I belong to a normal family. I belong to a normal family with brothers, sisters, nieces, nephews. I belong to a normal family and we have our own struggles as well. So I know. I know. But Jesus' love for us is unconditional. Merci bon Dieu, clason pa ka parler. Merci bon Dieu, de la motoka pa ka parler. Kalte bay ki ka fete motoka. Kalte bay ki ka fete behind closed doors. Merci bon Dieu. And God overlooks all of that. God loves us with an unconditional love. God loves us and he wants us to be free agents of that love. Free agents of that love. God's language of love was that he gave his, or he sent his son into the world to show us the extent of his love for humanity. And that because, you know, people, those persons at the time, their heads were so hard, they did not realize what was happening. Caused Jesus to go through, be mounted, carry his cross. And even then, carrying his cross, some people still were laughing and jeering at him. You know, I was listening to a program yesterday, and the priest was saying, you know, the greatest sin today is not abortion, is not the million-dollar industry of pornography, is not hate, is not envy. The greatest sin today, and John Paul said it during his pontificate, the greatest sin today is a loss of sense of sin. The loss of a sense of sin. That is very deep. That is very deep. And many of us, so-called Catholics, we have lost a sense of sin. That's why St. Lucia is in the state that it is today. That is why Babono is in the state that it is today, because we have lost a sense of sin. When I was growing up, my mother told me to respect your adults. Respect your adults. Now the young people are passing us on the streets and they don't greet us. And if you say to them, hey, but you could say morning, and the murder is there, kimunuko yeo. Huh? Isn't that true? Later simply see ye achwelma is because we are reaping what we saw a few years ago. We have lost respect. They don't respect priests now. A lot of y'all don't respect priests. Don't mind y'all sitting there. Y'all say the most atrocious things about priests. And y'all say it in the presence of your children. And your children hear it and they continue the same cycle. True or false? Those are highway porn. We have lost a sense of sin. Sisters and brothers, as we celebrate Easter, as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord, Christ, God has given us his language of love. What is your language of love? How do you show to others? How do you bring others to experience that love of God made visible in Jesus Christ? How? What is your language of love? You know, we've become so selfish. Me, myself, and I. The more you have, the more you want. To the point of you may step over people. You know, Jesus became selfless for us. Are you prepared to become selfless so that others may leave? You know, the Christian journey is serious business, eh? Serious business. And many times you take it for granted. You know, before the new translation of the Mass and the changes with the dismissals, there was a dismissal that we used before when Mass ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. You see, because when we are within those walls, we're on a high, and we're on a feel good. But Mass really begins when we go through this door. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. When you leave these doors, how are you going to love God? How are you going to serve God? Ekade di zoka peti mo left, right, and center. Pisa moun dizon abay, ebe zokwe moun dizon abay. And then you all come and receive communion on the same tongue. The same tongue you use to destroy your neighbors. The same tongue you use to curse people. The same tongue you use to gossip. You come and the priest say, body of Christ, ukadi amen. You know, we become fully church when we truly go out there to love and serve the Lord in our brothers and sisters. No matter creed, color, race, social status, political affiliation, sexual orientation. Because no one is to judge. Leave that to God. We are called to love unconditionally. Are you prepared today to love unconditionally? What is your language of love? As we celebrate that the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, let us embrace our own language of love. And let us show the world that we are different by how we love each other. Let us show the world that we are different. You know, Acts of the Apostles, you know, after the resurrection, you know, when all these things were happening, and you know, the persecution and all of those kind of things, you know, this group of men and women came together, you know, and they began to live, and they began to share everything, and they were living so well. People say, these people must be Christians. Look at how they love each other. Can that be said of us? That Babono people must be Christians. That St. Lucians must be Christians. Look at how they live well. With each other. Look at this. About people. And that is one of the sins that is taking over St. Lucia. We feel we can say what we want about people, how we want, where we want. Christians have respect for themselves and for each other because we see Christ in every other person. And I want to call on our leaders to be examples to our nation. And not only our civil leaders, I want to call on our spiritual leaders as well. Because some of us, we are cowards and we are afraid of preaching the gospel as we're supposed to preach it. We need at all times, we need to see Christ in the other person, no matter who they are. You know, it is providence that we have the sisters of the missionaries, the missionary sisters of charity with us. Their work, they do not discriminate. They attend to everybody as though they are a prince or princess in the kingdom of God. That's what they do. And we too are called to no less. We too are called to do the same. We too are called to show love to everyone, no matter who they are. Buju Bantan, I want to be loved, not for who you think I am, nor what you want me to be. Could you love me for me, real love, with no strings attached? I want to give you my heart. Don't want to take it back. And this is my chart. Look, I keep my mobile matter and set a glow. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls ourselves together, never apart. And when we learn to speak it, all the world will hear. Love in any language, fluently spoken here. Come on. Love in any language, straight from the heart, pulls ourselves together, never apart. And when we learn to speak it, all the world will say, love in any language, fluently spoken here. Love in any language. What is your language of love this morning? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you. I love Easter Sunday morning. You know, we renew our baptismal promises and pledge as a community to do better. So we stand. Friends, brothers and sisters, do you reject Satan? Do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin? Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness? Do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Amen. Repeat with me. This is our faith. This is the faith of the church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Yes. Can we get our candles lit, please? Altar servers. Ushers, could you help us, please, with the lighting of candles? You see, last night we had the candles from outside lit. Sunny went to for it. All our prayers to God, asking for mercy, asking for pardon for our country, for ourselves, for our families, and we present them to the Lord.
Our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. Amen.
We pray for the church, for Pope Francis, Bishop Gabriel, and all clergy, that they may continue to boldly preach the gospel and the hope of the resurrection, for the leaders of our nations and the world, inspired by the promise of hope in the resurrection, may they offer hope to those in greatest need through the distribution of the world's basic resources. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those received into the church at the Easter Vigil, supported by our prayers and encouraged by our witness. May they continue to grow in the understanding of the Paschal mystery, for peace in the world, in St. Lucia, in Haiti. May the hope of the resurrection bring reconciliation and lasting peace to countries torn apart by conflict and war. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the sick and the suffering. We pray for especially those who would have loved to be here but are unable to, those watching us via live stream, various social platforms and mediums, that they may find comfort in their faith and in the compassion of others. We pray for our parish community. May the light of Christ's victory over death inspire us in our care for one another, those in need, the poor, the weak, and the vulnerable. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And in the silence of our hearts, we add our personal needs and desires.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God, our Father, we thank you for listening to our prayers. We thank you for loving us in the midst of our brokenness, in the midst of our woundedness. We ask, Lord, to give us the graces we need so as to love others as Christ has loved us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated.
The family,
and at this time, we have our collection. And during this time, we'll sing with all our hearts and all our minds and all our beings. Number 371, the angel rolled the stone away.
So, the family of God is growing. Last night we had two baptisms, and this morning we have one, so we invite the family to come forward. So, brothers and sisters, we have one this morning. And what name do you give to the child?
Malachi.
Malachi, biblical. And what do you ask of God's church for Malachi?
Baptism.
You have asked to have your child baptized. In doing so, you are accepting the responsibility of training him in the practice of the faith. It will be your duty to bring him up to keep God's commandment as Christ taught us, by loving God and our neighbor. Do you clearly understand what you are undertaking? Godparents, are you ready to help the parents of this child in their duty as Christian parents? Malachi, the Christian community welcomes you with great joy. In its name, I claim you for Christ our Savior by the sign of his cross. I now trace the cross on your forehead and invite your parents and godparents to do the same. Since we have freshly blessed water from last night, so there's no need to bless water again. We have renounced our faith. We have renounced sin and profess our faith. We move to the next part. Parents, godparents, is it your will that Malachi should be baptized in the faith of the church which we have all professed with you? God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin, given you a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and welcomed you into his holy people. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so may you live always as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. Malachi, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. Seeing this white garment, the outward sign of your Christian dignity with your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. He is to walk always as a child of the light. May he keep the flame of faith alive in his heart. When the Lord comes, may he go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. The Lord Jesus made the deaf hear and the dumb speak. May he soon touch your ear to receive his word and your mouth, to proclaim his faith to the praise and glory of God the Father. And the church says, amen. Malachi, you have put on Christ. In him you have been baptized. Alleluia, alleluia. Sisters and brothers, this is the newest member of the Catholic community. We welcome you. You can go back to your seats or you can sit in the front bench if you want.
Shall we all stand for the offertory procession? As the presentation of gifts, we sing, "We Offer You."
We offer you bread and wine.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace to God, unite and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gabriel, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and we pray for all the living, for yourselves, for our family members, those who I would love to be here and are not here this morning for one reason or another. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you, for them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, celebrating the most sacred night, the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ. And blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O Lord, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your Son, of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord. We, your servants and your holy people, offer to you glorious, to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in your sight, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through the participation of at this altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants, and we pray for the dead, for all our deceased members of our families, deceased friends, and those who are dear to us, for all those who have died in St. Lucia to date through violence, through accidents. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us, mark with the sign of faith, and rest in the peace, in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, and Estacia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
So as we offer each other a sign of peace, let us offer, if you see anybody next to you who is a past student of CCSS, extend to them a special peace, because
I have been carrying the intention in my heart, but I have been forgetting to mention it as they celebrate their 50th anniversary. So special blessing to CCSS before they stone me. You see that Deacon want to do it in the sanctuary? Let's share the love. Let's share the love. Of God. Behold him, Jesus, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Christ, our Passover has been sacrificed. Alleluia. Therefore, let us keep the feast with the unleavened bread of purity and truth. Alleluia. Alleluia. The body of Christ.
For communion, we shall all join the choir in singing number 62, the Covenant Song.
Tree of life, you are washed in the blood. Exodus. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us, so Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sin was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, what a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is, nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, what a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is, nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, what a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is, nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus.
What a wonderful name it is. What a powerful name it is. Nothing, absolutely nothing, can stand against. What name?
Jesus.
The name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the notices.
Good morning again, brothers and sisters, and again, welcome, and again, happy Sunday to each and every one of you here present, and those of you watching us from another location. Today, Holy Mass, offered for the intention of all parishioners, 31st Sunday, Easter Sunday, Resurrection of the Lord. The prayer intention for Beryl Charles, Management and Staff of Rituals Iranura. For birthdays, Teresa Florius, Alban Louis, happy birthday, Jean Dosite Fede, and Jermaine Rambali. Happy birthday to all of you. praying for the anniversary of the deceased, Clement Daniel Florius, Peter Louis Joseph, his 4th year anniversary. Weekday notices. Monday, 1st April, no morning mass tomorrow. Tuesday, 2nd, 6 a.m., Holy Mass for Freda Anderson in honor of the Holy Spirit. Intentions, Judy Chastney and family. Intentions, Delmade family for blessings. Birthday intentions of Beverly Joseph Samuel for protection and guidance of the Holy Spirit and repose of the soul of Leonard Edmond. Wednesday, 3rd, 6 a.m., Holy Mass. Intentions for Alan Chastney and family for protection and good health. Intentions for Juliana Smith for healing in honor of St. Padre Pio. Birthday and wedding anniversary of Philip Justine. Birthday of Sherman Paul for guidance and protection. Thursday, 4th, 6 a.m., Holy Mass. In thanksgiving for Selma Garnier Carrasco in honor of Oscar Romero. Intentions for Alan Chastney for protection and good health. Friday, 5th at 6 a.m., again, Mass. Intentions for Freda Anderson in honor of the Holy Spirit and for Clita Saint-Gis for wisdom, perseverance, and good health. At 3 p.m., funeral service of Cynthia Melville. Just 1 second, we want to clarify. We proceed. 3 p.m., funeral service of Cynthia Minville. Saturday, 6 p.m., Vigil Mass, intentions for Beverly and Toyan Charlemagne, birthday of Samantha Docite, Cleopha Joseph and Jean Docite for blessings given by their daughter Agnes. The 50th wedding anniversary of Philip and Felicite Justin, given by their children. 75th birthday of, I beg your pardon for the pronunciation, P-I-E-D. Beg your pardon? Pierre de Teresa, if I mispronounce, my sincere apologies. In honor of the Holy Spirit. Birthday of Elaine Honora, offered in thanksgiving. And for Cleopha August Joseph. Sunday, second Sunday of Easter, is also referred to as Divine Mercy Sunday, Yebi. At 8 a.m., the Holy Mass will be offered for the intentions of all parishioners. Other notices. Easter Extravaganza. It is a family fun day on Sunday, 7th April, that is Sunday, next Sunday, from 11 a.m. onwards. Barbecue tickets. So the barbecue will be chicken, pork, and fish. These tickets will be on sale immediately after this Mass. This Mass? Tickets will be on sale immediately after Mass today. So your tickets cost only $25 EC. So bring it, bring your children, and come have a beautiful day. Well, miss it and blame yourself. So you don't have to cook. Just ashte tikea and have lunch, brunch, and dinner. The Balata service station is expanding. And I'm sure, for example, you have seen the Balata gas station at Balata that's expanding. So they will be hosting a job fair at the Babono Multipurpose Center on Saturday coming. Saturday, 6 April, from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. So, Power, please, supply the issue gas station nan ka ouvert, yo ka chercher moun pou travay, yo ka ni a job fair samedi ka vini a 9h pou 3h en multipurpose Babono. Pa 4way, 9h pou 3h. So all interested persons in Babono and surrounding communities seeking employment for full-time or part-time, you are asked to attend. The positions that are open are service ambassadors, cashiers, supervisors, forecourt captains, and merchandisers. Work with your curriculum vitae, your ID card, as you will be interviewed on the same day. And if you have your own references, your reference letters. So ID card, curriculum vitae, ex-uni reference, and please, please, young people, as you are, always remember to dress appropriately for an interview. Animators and lectures for next weekend as follows. On Saturday night, animator, Sister Teresa Daisy, no lecture one, but lecture two will be Shakira Samuel. Sunday, 7th, Divine Mercy Sunday, our animator will be Sister Cora Alfred. Lecture one, Natalie Bridget. Lecture two, Brother Wayne Benty. Sorry, Sister Natalie Bridget. Cleaning of the church next weekend will be done by the community of Lakwa Shobo, and it will be followed by the community of Gara. Here ends the notices.
Thank you very much. Good morning, sisters and brothers. So last year was the test run for the Easter extravaganza. So this year is the real Mokoi. There can be no better Easter extravaganza anywhere on the island. But where? Second to none. We are trendsetters, not copycat. So we invite everybody. So all those persons following us on live stream from Miku, Monripo, Soufre, Canries, Anslere, Cathedral, Grosilay, Marchand, wherever you are, don't go spending your money wild, because we need your money in Babono on April the 7th. Come out. It promises to be good. Okay? It promises to be good. The tickets, those who are without tickets, we have tickets outside. As soon as you leave, you can purchase your tickets. But we want all unsold tickets to be returned by Thursday, because we need to know what we're doing moving forward. We will also have a ticket booth on the day outside, so you can purchase tickets. The raffle books, if you're not complete, make sure you bring them back so we can know how to, you see, because we are business people, eh? So we need to know if we have not achieved a certain figure, how do we strategize and change the marketing ploy over the next few days. You understand? Yes, so we have to get maximum profit, because we have work to do. On Thursday at 9 a.m., all those who are able, all those who are willing, all those men and women, pass them to sell, eh? Men and women, we need help to clean the chicken, clean the pork, clean the fish, to season it. We have season to clean, we have some season to clean and to chop. If anybody is willing, you know, you can collect it. Because my house is closed tomorrow and today and Tuesday, because Tuesday is the day off. So, but we need to get stuff done. So please let us come together to help, so that we can make this extravaganza second to none. Bon, chicken n'a besoin saisonner properly depuis jeudi. Puis si pan gou, mwen premier kaidi pan gou. Okay? So please, let us come out, let us help, so that we can make this extravaganza family-oriented, fun-filled, but we need to realize, like some businesses out there, maximum profits. So again, we beg you for your donations. Last year, you did very well with the donations. This year, again, we are asking you for your donations. So, se muna ki achete one pack la, banu a bouteille di dan. Se muna ki achete comme case la bière, banu a case di dan. You understand? So that, you see, because if you are doing a fundraiser, it must be minimum expenses and maximum, yes. If you're doing a fundraiser, it cannot be maximum expenses. It must be minimum or no expenses and maximum profit. So please, brothers and sisters, assisters, those of you all overseas, you can send the money through Western Union or a MoneyGram. We are arranging with one of the financial institutions so that you can click and send your donations directly to our account. That is on its way. It's work in progress. So please, let us make this Family Day second to none. And it's open to everybody. Everybody. The only persons that are not invited are the people who are going to come and make Roro. Because Name Yudo. These are the people that are not invited. Some people, anywhere they go, they must end up fighting and those kind of things. In Babono, we don't want that, we don't support that. Amen? Yeah. On Saturday, we as the Catholic Church, we have organized a 9 churches pilgrimage to pray against crime and violence in St. Lucia. And we are starting at the cathedral. The video is coming up. We are starting at the cathedral and we are going around the island. Buses are being arranged so that persons can participate. We need persons from Babono as well to participate because we are going around the island and we are doing stops at various churches. So please, wear something blue, wear something white. Okay? 9 church pilgrimage against crime and violence in St. Lucia. So please, we are inviting everyone or as many people as possible to attend this pilgrimage. All right? We thank the people of Bourges for cleaning the church last week and there were 2 persons who do not belong to Bourges, but they came to clean the church, so we thank you very much. I want the collections to go back up. You know, so we thank you for that. Isn't that church beautiful? Isn't that church beautiful? So, the gold cloth you are seeing there is $24.95 a yard. And I had to buy 20 yards. I'm giving you no, you see, because Nukavini Nukawebai Bell, but we need to have an idea of the costs. So the gold cloth is $24.95 a yard, and we had to buy 20 yards. Do the maths yourselves. All the white flowers you are seeing there compliments my friend from Soufre. So after service on Friday, I had to drive to Soufre to go and pick up those flowers. So my friends provided all these flowers. You see how people outside of the parish interested? So you too have to interest yourself as well. True or false? So we say thank you to the person who donated us the flowers. Even baby breath Munabanui. Baby breath Sherry. No? Yes, baby breath is expensive. The person even gave us baby breath and all the white flowers was given to us. So we thank God and we pray for them that the Lord would reward them 100-fold. This week, tomorrow morning, there is no Mass. However, we will have Mass Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday morning at 6 a.m. After Mass is finished, whether you see me or you don't see me, I am not there. No, I'm very serious. Don't come to my house unless you have an emergency. Yesterday, somebody called, Father, what time is Mass? You know, I need to catch my breath. From the time the year started, I've been going. I am not energizer battery. So I need to take it slowly. So this week, the office will be open on Wednesday, closed on Thursday, open on Friday. However, whether you see me or you don't see me, the only way I will answer you is if you have an emergency for somebody to be anointed. The only way I will answer you or attend to you is if I have an emergency or of somebody needing anointing. Are we clear? Yes, yeah, sometimes we need to be selfish for our own selves so that we don't die in the process. No, it's true. It's true. So please, you know, so look at that. Say famla fun kosi nomla. Now, I believe, I want to thank you for your contributions, but I believe that the men could have done a little better. Even if they don't match or surpass the ladies, I believe the men could have done a little better. They find it easy to push their hand in their pocket and buy a bottle of whiskey with their friends. Not true? Yes, they find it easy to pay for a carnival costume and pay for one for the Jabal too. No, I believe the men could have done a little better. Rory, looking forward, that's all right. It's Easter Sunday, we can relax. Right? But thank you very much for your contributions. So when you see Lenten Mission, 50% of that has to go to the bishop's office. And every Sunday, whatever we collect every Sunday, 20% of it has to go to the bishop's office. So what we collect does not always stay here. What we collected on Good Friday, entirely, it goes to the Holy Land. You know, so again, I just want you to know what happens to your monies. So thank you very much for your contributions. Thank you for your participation. Thank you for your commitment. Speaking about commitment, we spoke about on Thursday, we spoke about the envelopes. Before I came, you had Typhing Sunday. And we've changed that because I don't like the word typhing. You know, covenant. Making a covenant with God. Right? On a monthly basis. And some people are saying, oh, well, they don't want to take the 9 envelopes and all of those kind of things. A covenant is a commitment with God. A covenant is a commitment with God. We are not asking you to give what you don't have. No. We are asking you to make a commitment that every month, the last Sunday of every month, you will give something to your parish. And it will go to the development of your church. You understand? If God see you don't have $200, don't say, but yeah, I wanted to give, you don't give. God knows your heart. All right? There's a lot to be done. Don't mind the church. If you walk in the sanctuary, the tiles are like a seesaw. I'm just hoping that it does not flip one of those days while we are here, that it hurts somebody. So that has to be done. The tabernacle area has to be done. If you look, the tiles are falling off the wall. Look at it. So there's a lot to be done. So when, you know, I'm asking, you know, for a covenant offering the last Sunday of every month, that's not your normal collection. It is your special offering. Because let me tell you, we cannot thank God enough for what he has done for us. True or false? We cannot thank God. Look at how many of us are here this morning. Usav Kome. For why quick rumbly half a matin? No, a number of persons did not wake up this morning, but we woke up and we are here. And how do we say thank you to God? How do we say thank you to God? When you give money in the parish, you are not giving it to me. You are not giving it to Albert Aaron Smith, Pamon Kabali. You're giving it to your parish. And you have seen what is being done with your money. Not true? Not true? Yes, you have seen what is being done with your money. So we will show you what we want to do with the money you have in your pocket and in the bank that you need to give the church what rightfully belongs to the church. Let's see the video. That is also Naha Baklakak. I got a VA. I got a 90-putty Bank of St. Lucia, First National Power, 10 Puzo Leather. How much money you have in the bank there? It don't grow yet. They're growing again. So our toilet facilities that we want, that is what it's going to look like. Have a look. So that's what we wanted, and right. So this building, we will knock it down, and we will do the toilet and the sacristy along each other. We had some pictures, but they can't find it on the computer. We had it on Thursday, so it's going. Yes. So right there will be the sacristy and the toilet block joined together, and that is what the toilet facility will look like, second to none. Last night somebody says, Father, I don't see the hand dryers. So if you want hand dryers, push your hand in your pocket and we will order the hand dryers. Not true? Yes. So, but we have to, my thing is, anyone who need to use the toilet facility, the bathroom facility, should not be not able to use it because of your disability or anything of that matter. Everybody should be able to use it and use it comfortably. Okay? Yes. So also we might have to ask Bryce and company or whoever the tank people are, so we can do water harvesting as well. So we can have water. All right? Yes, so that is it. And thank you for all your contributions. They have a lot of people who retire with a lot of money in the bank. We need some, please. Pakite la pu ishu gume pu lila o mo. Subanu timiet ikale de botwavai. Usadi, I gave something to the church for their projects. And I know when you do that, the Lord will reward you 100-fold. Not true? Not true? Not true? Wepon pismo vle wase munaka wepon na pumesa takso apwe. Yes, yes. So thank you very much. Now, during the crusade outside, somebody borrowed a chair that does not belong to the Menevie. No, that's not a laughing matter. Munaki pwete chairs la salve ipate vignette chairs. A plastic chair, a white plastic chair. If we do not get it, we have to pay the owner for it. If somebody loan us their chairs, muna upasa point. A low point, a good point, se pasa uye, se vole kila. Makakuye mun vole, mwe just ka di. So the person who borrowed the chair, please return the chair, because we need to return the chair to the owner. The Sunday we had, the Saturday we had the Jesus Jam. Apparently, phones in Babono walking. Amun point a phone amun. Bozo paka by power slavie no abanum abamwe. Okay? So whoever took the person's phone and may have changed the SIM card already, return the phone, because you never know when you hold it there, ikaibule fijayu. You never know. Ek mak phone nakai weste lapu tutmunwe sakivo. Please return the person's phone. That is not charitable. That is not
charitable. What you do not want for yourselves, please do not want it for somebody else. The same way everybody have all the information on their phones, the person had all the information on their phone. It is not yours. Munaki pwete chez la sou hot mene vie, just kite yan la kou l'église la nou ka yen ni. Ebe kite do prezite la nou ka yen ni. But return the person's chair. The person's phone, please bring it back. You can, when the church open, leave it on the bench, we'll get it. But it's not yours and you should not take it. I don't subscribe to these kind of behaviors. Okay? Am I missing anything? That's it. I want to welcome the sisters this morning worshiping with us. Sisters, welcome and feel free, you know, to come at any time. Yes. I see a number of visitors here. One of them was waving for CCSS. I want to know what school you go to. No, she went to DJSS. First DJSS. Now, Wanu. So Marcia and myself went to Denwi Junior Sec together. She lives in the U.S. Thank you for worshiping with us. And we want to welcome all of our visitors. Let me see all the visitors. Welcome to all of our visitors. There are more visitors there, I know. Yes, yes. Oh, we love you, love you, love you. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Oh, we love you, love you, love you.
No matter what you do, for we behold the risen Christ in you.
Thank you. Please stand. And thank you to all those who sent me the aqua with a lot of selfish. Thank you very much. Mwen jwen, oui, yo di, ti akwa vle, yo vweye akwa vini. Merci en pile. Yes. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing and respond amen after every invocation.
May God bless you through today's Easter solemnity and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he restore you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten, endow you with the price of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrating in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, alleluia, alleluia.
And prosperous Easter to all of you, but also we want to wish all past CCSS students a happy 50th anniversary. And we continue to pray for you. We continue to pray for the success of the school. We continue to pray for the principal, the staff, and students of the school so that the Lord would continue to bless them and so that they may take their rightful place in society in building our country.
On behalf of all CCSs, thank you very much, Father. Look to this day. Before we close, sisters and brothers, just allow me, Father, 1 second. Tomorrow starts April month, and tomorrow starts Youth Month. And sisters and brothers, I just want you to look around the church and see the young people who are participating in media coverage. Everyone behind the camera, in front of the camera, at a computer, is a young person. In the choir, conducting choir, young person. Musicians, techno, tech, ITV, you call it, you name it. In the technology covering today's mass, young people. Altar servers, young people. I want you to give our young people a round of applause and wish them Happy Youth Month starting from tomorrow.
Thank you.
And as we leave, we'll sing the Easter song. Sing hallelujah, the Lord is risen. He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
Let us all sing this song together. Let us join the choir, number 71, the Easter song.
She won.